Now, liberals were probably very confident about this issue when RBG was still on the court, but now that the court has a conservative majority, we might be seeing some much-needed changes to this controversial health care policy. Joining me now from Dallas, Texas, financial expert and co-founder and chief strategist of GDP Advisors, Seth Denson. Now, Seth, I know that you don't have a crystal ball here, but what are your predictions when it comes to Obamacare?
Yeah, my prediction is, and again, based on what I've heard off of the arguments that have already happened today, is that the Affordable Care Act will be kept intact. The limited time that I had to review some of what the questioning was back and forth, it sounds very much like John Roberts will go like he did in 2012 and support the upholding the law, but it also sounded like Brett Kavanaugh was leaning that way as well based on his questioning.
Yeah, and you look at polling, it always shows that the majority of Americans are somewhat satisfied with Obamacare, which leaves me kind of confused because, again, most of the people I've talked to, their deductibles went up. They're unsatisfied with the health care plans that they were forced into. So why is that?
Well, Americans, by and large, I think have short-term memory, and the devil you know beats the devil you don't. And we haven't seen anything since the passage of the Affordable Care Act come from Republicans, and so you're kind of left with, well, this is what we have, and I don't want it to go away. And Americans have, by and large, gotten used to it. Now, to your point, Stephanie, costs have gone up, and that's in large part because the Affordable Care Act did nothing to reduce the cost of health care. It just provided more health insurance on the backs of taxpayers. And so much like anything that the government gets involved in, costs tend to go up. So it's going to continue to go up. It's going to continue to be a burden for taxpayers if we don't actually do something about real health care reform.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, obviously, we still don't know who the next president of the United States is. This is, of course, if you're not going off of what the networks are saying. What is the market reaction this week so far? We've heard that Wall Street and so on, they don't really care who the president is. In fact, a lot of them supported Biden. So what can we expect?
I think the markets do care who the president is, but the markets like limited government involvement, especially if this current situation that the government has created is positive. And so let's just kind of take a step back and realize the economic system that the Trump administration had put in place. And if you move forward, even with a Joe Biden presidency, and the Republicans can hold the Senate, right, then the odds of radical shift of our economic system are slim. And the markets like that. They like stability. They like the government to kind of stay out of things. And a divided government means that they're probably going to get both of those things.
Yeah. Now I want to shift gears here. Apparently tens of thousands of companies may have wrongly received PPP money. This isn't the first time I've heard this. I've actually heard stories of people who know other business owners who received lots of money. They didn't even really put it into their businesses. They ended up like buying boats and fancy cars and all this crazy stuff. So this news report, I'm not surprised by at all.
Your government at work, right? Your government's ability to manage money and the flow of money. This is a shame. And in the month of September alone, the United States government saw over right around 2,500 complaints, which is more than they normally see in a year, of misuse of this funds. And even companies that were on the do not get money list, there actually was a list, Stephanie, that said, do not send these people money. Guess what? We sent them money. Guess who didn't get a lot of money? Small businesses. And so this is, again, going back to something you and I have discussed now for months, which is expediency over accuracy is a failure. And if we are going to talk about another stimulus, we need to make sure we know what we're doing.
Well, and it's pretty sad that some of these businesses that didn't qualify for it, didn't really need it, were taking money away from the small businesses that actually needed it, because I know a lot of business owners who received zero help from the government were completely forced to shut down. And so it really just it takes away from the people who really needed it. And you think about what's going to happen in this upcoming flu season, and we see the kind of like the restrictions and things that are looming again. California might be going into a purple zone again. We saw what's happening in New York. I mean, there's going to be some challenging times ahead.
There is. The crystal ball is very hazy right now, and it's most foggy for small business owners. We need to support these people. We need those programs that were put in place to be in place for them, and these large fat cats and people that shouldn't have gotten this money. It's shameful.
Yeah. I shared a meme yesterday of how businesses are moving outdoors and they're like putting up tents. So you can sit inside a tent in a parking lot, but you can't sit inside a restaurant. Doesn't really make sense, but, you know, What's up is down.
It's the same as people not being able to catch COVID at Walmart, but they can catch it at church. I mean, this whole thing has been, where's the consistency?
Yeah, and also just like Trump rallies are super spreader events, yet if you're celebrating a potential Biden victory, that's all, it's all good. Anyways, we got to run. Thank you.
Thanks, Steph.